This is my third video on the Majolica method of decorating tiles. It covers putting the design onto transparent paper, pouncing it, and marking it with carbon powder onto the tiles. This is St. Geordie painted. In this video, I am going to prepare the tiles with the design, and in the next, I'm going to paint it. Each tile is coded on the back with a number and a letter. They always start at the left-hand corner, which is the one the builder starts working with. The letters go up vertically and the numbers go horizontally. Here are the designs on transparent paper, prepared to be pounced. There are 8, 2 tiles on each piece. This is the first 2 tiles, A1 and A2, and next to it is a pin pencil. To make one, hold a pin in pliers and stick it deeply into the flat end of a pencil. Hold the pencil in your left hand and with the pliers in your right, cut off the head of the pin. Pull out the pin, turn it, and stick the cut end into the hole left in the pencil. Now it is finished, and for safety, stick it into a bit of rubber. Lay the design on top of a piece of material, so when it is pounced, the pin goes right through. Flip it over and pounce it in reverse. Pounce all the outlines. It is better to do this through the back so the rough edge is not against the glaze. Pouncing is a long, boring job. The smaller the holes and the nearer together they are, the better it marks. This is a close-up of the 16-tile design we are going to paint through this video. Here we have everything that is needed to mark the design onto the tiles. A crank with the 16 tiles prepared to use. A marking bag. The design on tracing paper and pounced. The paint to mark the numbers on the back and water to clean the brushes. Glaze to repair any tiles if needed. Take out the first tile and on the back paint its code and number. This one is A1. Leave it on the table. Take out the next tile and number it A2. Put it next to the first tile. Put the first 2 designs, A1 and A2, on transparent paper on top of the tiles. Place it correctly and hold it in place. Rub over it with the marking bag. Tap the bag onto it so the carbon powder comes out. Then rub over it with the bag so it goes through the pounced holes. Lift up a corner to check it is well marked. If not, repeat it. Now, take off the transparent paper. This is a close-up of the 2 tiles. When correct, put the tile back into the crank and continue marking all the rest. Now they are prepared. Take them to where you paint. Take out the tiles one by one and place them on the stand in the correct order. Here are the first tiles. Always put one line of biscuit tiles between the wooden bar and the tiles prepared to decorate. This keeps all the dust, colours and dirt that falls off while working from touching them. This is the last line of the tiles. This is the whole design marked on with carbon powder. This video is finished. I have prepared all the tiles. In the next video, I'm going to prepare the colours and paint the tiles.